companies, bad for your company. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. Got in the ski mask, in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't wanna eat. If you say they want, they don't want no steam. She put it on it. Had a bachelor's degree, PhD while selling, fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self-esteem. Hit a block, yo, this flop. Where you at? Pin it. My new map location be the fly on the app.
Any money in company? Nah, babe. I don't need no the company.
You can't hang, baby. We don't want you around here. I'm ice on my neck and it's froze. Santa's reindeer. You got bad. It's the same here. Bad company, lil' bro. You can't hang here. Getting money, so the keep on coming. So you know the jumping. They looking at me. He owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the not a crumpet.
Why
playing games? They don't want no problems with me. My got good. You know I brought some. Might not hit a bad. Someone for them. Well, opposition. So I
dark shades. Too much. Got the belly seat up. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks? Who want too close? Give me room, pony folks. Play it close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue Dunker Freeze. Flintstone, bust down, call it Maricami. Fruity Pebble, Bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Bad, I'm out of town, I think she model Abercrombie.
Thank you, Coach. From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New York Jets and the Miami Dolphins. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Here go 47.
Safety creeping.
What do you think?
First carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. There to stop him was Darius Leonard.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, these big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Wait a second. Hey, 47.
On play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Escaping. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long.
That is right.
Gun. Go 47, 26.
Now Prescott. He's going to look deep down the field. Looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line. Last week, somehow they won. He threw all those picks, but they still won here opening drive. Unfortunately, he picked up where he left off.
Partner, you get a lot of extra patience when you find a way to win despite you making mistakes. But starting out again this game, that patience is going to wear thin really quick. And I think the guys on the defensive side of the ball will be the first ones to let him know.
Come on!
Got to stop.
Back to throw Barrett. Fred. Going underneath for Lewis. Finding room to the 20. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. First foray into the red zone for Miami. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Working out of the gun, it's Barrett. Throw right. Right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. An inside give. And here he'll get it down to the 7. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
Well, after that pickup of a first down, I think some of the defensive guys are going to be looking over their coordinator and saying that was not in the scouting report. That went against every tendency most teams have. You don't usually hand the ball to your big guy in that situation. Sometimes you catch him by surprise.
They'll try and run for it, first and goal. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Barrett now on second down. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up 4 last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Throwing here, Barrett. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback because he's not being hit. As you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
So a pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted 6, but they got 3 in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over.
Start there, over here. Over here. Start there.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. It's complete to Jerron Brown. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They'll pitch it out to Elliott. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Hey, you're on an island over there. You're on
an island. 47. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they?
just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10.
Come on, let's go!
They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
190!
Out of the pistol, it's McCoy. Nice footwork by McCoy. How did he stay on his feet? And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. 34 yards there and a first down.
Our eyes and attention are on the fullback. Big time carry, big yardage. But how about the guys up front, the offensive line? A lot of people think they may have to block it differently for the fullback to get big yardage. They really don't. Because he's big, strong, and powerful, a lot of times he makes his own way. They may not have to block as hard.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line.
Let's go!
They give it to him running left, and he stopped immediately there. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. So stuff for no gain on second down brings up a pretty interesting third from this distance.
I'm throwing the ball, and I'm
going to... And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Andrew Billings able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage, and it'll be fourth down. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
This will be taken in at the 1. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now the Jet offense about to take over as they head out onto the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit? Like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
Good.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half in some of these shorter gains.
Yeah. Here's another interception, the 3rd of this first quarter. Picked off at the 15.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is 3rd down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
Tight is right. Watch tight.
Tight is right.
Let's go.
They start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Tight end right, tight end right.
Here we go. Brad 38. Brad 38.
Check, check. 3 down, 3 down.
Cut.
On 2nd down, Barrett. Under pressure and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back. Nice man, complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A gain of 39 that time. So the line of scrimmage all the way up to midfield now as they've got it first and 10.
Now let's go. Boom.
Now they try the right side here. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Three down.
Here we go.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. Anunua's got it. Complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
This is third and one. Very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though.
Blue 90. Blue 90.
56
to
Mike, boys. 56. Check 56.
They'll set up a throw. And he's got a noon one. And eventually taken down, but how about that athletic spin move we saw? Gives him the first down yardage. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Throw here on first down. Flushed out right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Green, 39.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And here he's got Grant. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down. This quarterback now 4 of 5 since coming on. It's first and 10. They'll run him out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends. They're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
A third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down.
We got four. Now let's go.
On third, here's an option play right. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will make our score 9-0. So that one is his third of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high, as he once had 6 field goals.
Brandon, but 6?
Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. The New York set to take the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Second down, Prescott. He'll rifle this one deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 67 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
First red zone opportunity now for the Jets. They've got a first and goal just inside the five. Now Elliott. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. They'll run for it with Tariq Cohen. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy in the game right now.
Pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. He just never materialized.
Here's Elliott. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Ezekiel Elliott, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. And they're back within a couple at 9-7 now. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. Uses the spin. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And out come the Dolphins now. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gassed,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
They'll start off with a give to Lewis. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Here we go now.
Second down. Here's an option right. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Miami after this.
He wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Justin Reed, the safety, made the tackle.
Now, that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
Set! Green 39! Green 39! Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
They'll set up to throw. The Jets pressure too much as down he goes. Andrew Billings in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
The Dolphins on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 15.
All right, now, look at 56.
They'll drop the throw. Wide open receiver complete. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
Scrimmage. Call it a loss of 2 on the play, and it'll be 2nd and 12.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Lewis has the first down and then some. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Deion Lewis, as the first half is winding down, and the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, almost had the feel of imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Extra point up and good by Bailey. And that makes this a 9-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Just 18 seconds remain till halftime as they come up on 1st and 10. First down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, 2nd down. Line of scrimmage. Again, the 25. 2nd and 10.
Over here. Start there. Here we go, 46. 53 to Mike. Here you go. 26.
On 2nd down, Prescott again. He's airing it out for Sanu. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
Here we go, get that. Let's go, get out, get out. 47.
Let's go, let's go.
Sweat, sweat, and
A. Final play of the half, Prescott. Diluting the pressure right. Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got it out. And here now is Finn. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week 3 matchup. So the two teams will head to the locker rooms here in Miami with the Dolphins on top. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. You're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run down. Didn't happen on that play.
And not a whole lot doing there, so get it up to about the 28-yard line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7. Able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. He's up to 70 yards receiving now as that last catch gets him a first down. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Complete. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. This down about the 21 or 22. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really about to hurt you. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And that's going to be incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've hit 4 of 7. This time they face a 3rd and 2.
Everyone's got 4. 4 down.
Now let's go!
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to fourth down. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will give him a 12-point lead. So making 4 out of 4 now in the field goal department, and he's able to extend their lead.
When drives have bogged down, he's been automatic out there. So nice to have a kicker you can count on to put points on the board.
This fielded at the 2. And it winds up a terrific return, but markers are down. And this is going to come all the way back. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on 1st and 10.
Slam.
A 1st down throw for Prescott. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off around the 41. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39. Detroit!
The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Got an open man. It's a good one. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That one goes for 24 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a 1st down.
He's tight right here. He's tight on the right. Tight on the right. All right, now. Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Detroit! Detroit!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. A great effort there with his 1st career NFL touchdown. And the Dolphins add on to their lead. And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the 1st touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation, is there? You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done. He's got to feel great right now.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded at the 2. And an alley to run. And he will take this one all the way back inside the 35-yard line.
We all know the teams never want to use the word panic. But if they expect to win this game, it has to start right here, right now. That return just set them up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. And he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Prescott now on second down. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. you're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
What do you think?
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Looking for the end zone. Got a man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Ray McLeod, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Jets are able to cut into this deficit. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Extra point good by Catanzaro, and that will shave one more off this lead. Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Then the Dolphins getting set to go here. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll run it now. Out of bounds. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position. And we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sideline.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. A beautiful spin and room to run. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for 33 and a first.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So the big play gets them across midfield now for first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39, green.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Tight end, and he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10.
Gone, 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 gone.
Running on the toss, and he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10.
I'm going to hit you all day.
Hurry up. Here we go.
And they'll go ground game here with a touchback. He's going to get four out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football. It's also Dolphin lead to begin quarter number four. The 7. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Now let's go! Green!
On third down. That's Wilson. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Give him a gain of 4. Able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll come out in the pistol. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second and goal from the 6 this time.
Last stop!
Leopard! Leopard!
Kill, kill, kill!
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
He's going to get it running right. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. They're down here in the 4th, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage.
We got 4.
We got 4. Now let's go! 3!
And he'll turn it around again to try to get in. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
Here we go now. 3-19!
They get it to him running left. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. He lost 2 there. And it's third down.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
Now they've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal?
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Through. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So yet another field goal to end a drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And New York set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here we go, 46.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Give him 30 yards there. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you guys could maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And this is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, and that'll bring up second down.
The touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. He's going to let this one go deep. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On play action, Prescott. He's going to air one out. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Wait, Here we go, 46. 46.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And Ginn's got it. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Gun. 26.
Prescott on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Nelson Agholor, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets are able to close the gap just a bit. And his kick is good. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. Right now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays that are going to gain yardage, consistently. Right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal? End the game, would you?
LeSean McCoy off to the races. 20, 10, and all the way in for a Miami touchdown. LeSean McCoy, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. Here's Bailey now for the extra point. Bailey got the extra point, and the lead is up to 15 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
On first and 10, Prescott looking deep downfield. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him.
Gun.
On third down, it's Prescott.
I can't believe they let you play.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
46. 47. Here we go, 46. 46.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he's got Sanu. And out across midfield, down to the 45. Time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down.
And they pick up the first down on a fourth down play. I don't know if the defense relaxed because they thought maybe they'd stopped them on third down, or if they just didn't protect the sticks very well. But boy, that's a big time pickup right there.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there, hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. He spins free. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards on the pickup there as they'll be left with third and one. On third and one, here's Prescott. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Nelson Agholor, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Jets are able to cut into this deficit.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the broadcast.
You know, I just grab the nugget when I can.
And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
after the loss to start out. Here's second and 11. Hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
The Dolphins on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 11. To throw. Good footwork at the 30. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They'll run him now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Got to figure the rush is going to be fierce again as they come up second and 13.
All right, here we go. 319! 319!
On play action, they'll throw.
Here we go.
Throwing left side, it's complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They give him a gain of 38. And we continue to see another example here of offenses just going for it.
And this game has really turned into a receiver's dream and a defender's nightmare, because no one's being stopped throwing the ball downfield, and points are going on the board.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Officially salt this one away. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Check. Hurry up. Here we go. 319.
They give it to him up the middle. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. They've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal?
Hurry up. Here we go.
Off the toss, Lewis. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. And 3 yards on the carry there as his defense holds strong and takes it to fourth and goal. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know, people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with 3 or 4 home runs mixed in.
So for the Dolphins, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2 on the young season. And they'll have another home date next week as the Indianapolis Colts come to town. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they will fall to a similar mark at 1-2. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Dallas Cowboys. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.